Hello, it's Sara, and today I'm going to be doing the February art journal page. So last month we did this guy, the Heart of Winter for January, and I was just playing with new products that I had and kind of came up with this design. I'm going to try and do this similarly this month. I have two stencils that I've never used. Well, I actually did just use this one because I wanted to have a dry one to work with. So this is a Crafters Workshop stencil called Mini Bricks, and then I have this one called Mini Time Travel. Never used them. I have these are my Jacquard paints, Jacquard Lemure paints. These are all metallic paints, and they're a bit expensive, but I have these, so I want to use these. I don't use them a lot. They're actually fabric paints, I think. They're light body metallic acrylic. Anywho, because my thought is, with the bricks and the clocks, I think I'm going to do spring is almost here, so time is passing. The bricks are the cold of winter, but the clock represents that spring will soon be here. So I've cut a piece of 12 by, what is this? I don't know. Mixed media paper in half, 9 by 12. So I cut it in half, 9 by 6. And I'm going to use that. Now the one that I already did is had gesso on it. I'm not going to gesso this one, and we're just going to see how it goes. So I want you to use what you have, as always. This is modeling paste. And again, I've had it, and I never do this, guys. Like, if you watch my videos, I think you can count on one hand, or fewer than that, how many times I've ever used modeling paste. So we're going to do it. And, I mean, it looks pretty empty, but it's I really haven't used it very much. I'm going to take my stencil and just apply this modeling paste. And I know a lot of people do it with a credit card or whatever. Just use what you have. So it's not, this is just for the background. And I haven't done anything to this. I said that already. All right. But I am just going to spread this through the holes in the stencil. Try to get pretty even coverage. Now, bricks are made of clay. So having any bumps and ridges is going to work perfectly because I don't care. My bricks are going to be handmade bricks. So I'm just trying to get a smoothish impression and pick up some of the paste as well so I don't leave my stencil just covered in it. And then I'm going to flip it and do the other side as well. So a few over here. I'm trying to do this fast. I don't want to take too long. My videos are very long, and I think it must just be, it has the most to do with I talk a lot. Well, that's one thing. But also that I do them in real time. So you're just kind of there with me through all the mistakes and all the thought process. So for anyone who's afraid to try this, they see it's not scary. Just do it. Just play. And so that's what I'm trying to get across, oops, this year especially, because it's been a process for me, art journaling, and I'm finally getting it now. I understand that it's not a finished page every time. Doesn't have to be anyway. Just because I'm finishing a page, it doesn't have to be a finished page. You can just play with modeling paste one day, and that's all it is. So for today, yeah, I'm going to finish this page, but that's not what it has to be. I'm just going to move this. Actually, that's what I got. And this modeling paste kind of does have the texture of paste. Like, So look, and I mean, there's even some right there. All right, I'll move that away. But I'm going to set that aside because I have a dry one. I did one already so that I would have, we wouldn't have to wait for that to dry when I do my next step. Which, guys, I have no idea what this will look like at the end. But that's the idea. You just want to play. So you don't even have to do it exactly like I'm doing it. But if it helps me when I follow the teacher exactly, because then I don't have to think about anything, but I still get the fun of playing and learning the technique. So I'm just going to cover that up. Now, I'm thinking I want to do a blue background for sky, although you can pick any background color. You can pick whatever you want to do. This happens to be deep midnight blue because I didn't want it to be black. That's really why I'm choosing blue, because I wanted a dark background color, but I didn't want it to be black. I'm going to water. I'm going to blot my brush, and I'm just going to see what happens. I'm going to go over the entire background. Not necessarily covering the whole entire thing. Like, I don't mind if there's bits of white showing, but I need a little more paint. I do want to cover the background pretty much because I'm going to do other things, but I want a background. I'm just adding water to make the paint. This is acrylic paint. I'm a bottle baby. And it's not heavy body or light body. It's just kind of craft paint. All right, so that's it. I'm just going to let that dry. I just wanted to get some color on there. I think I'm going to use some metallic rubs, and I have the Viva Inca Gold. There's a lot of different rubs on the market. Well, Rub and Buff, DecoArt Americana, Media, it's DecoArt Media, right? Have come out with these metallic rubs as well. So use what you have, and if you don't have any, you can use paint. It's okay. You could probably use a metallic paint. So I'm going to go away and dry this, and I'll be back with the next step. All right, it's dry. I'm going to use now Whispering Turquoise. I don't have a clue why, guys. I just like it. I like the color, and I'm going to use my brayer. This is the little Ranger brayer. And I've been using my brayer a lot more lately. Again, it's something I don't tend to use, so I'm trying to use it more. And I do like the way the brayer puts the paint on the surface. It's a very rough, dry brushy look. And so I'm starting to just use it more. And I mean, I got a little more, you know what, maybe I'll go back with the blue. Because you can. I had a little blue on my palette, so I just went over it. But I think that already kind of adds a little highlight and a rustic look, right? So instead of using white, I just chose to use blue. Alright, we're going to let that dry. And because it's so dry brushy, it doesn't take long to dry at all. So this is the brayer. It's just a little, this is the small one. There's lots of different size brayers. You know what? I'm going to take a piece of deli paper and just take some paint and put it on there. Oh, it didn't go. Because this is what I'm learning from Wonderlust too, is that just use a piece of scrap paper, even printer paper, just regular copy paper, and pick up the paint on your palette instead of wasting it, and just do it in a very artsy fartsy way, you know, and then, you know, who knows what it'll turn out like, but at least you're not wasting the paint, and then I have a clean palette to start with. So let's see, should we do, you know what, I do have this stamp. This is a brick stamp, and I just thought, well, why not? I really do like, I'll stick with the theme. I never use this. I mean, honestly, guys, that's my inspiration here. Using things I don't have. So because this is a brick stamp, I'm just going to stamp, and you can't really see it because it's in black. I could use a different color, but maybe I don't need it. I mean, you can see it kind of, but I'm just going to, that was kind of not, it was a fail-ish, right? So, before I do any metallic rubbing, I want to get these clocks on here. And I think I'm just going to put them on with, I don't want to cover the brick. I think I'm going to do it with white and a piece of makeup sponge. Yeah, I think I'm going to do white. No, you know what? I'm going to use the metallic paint, but I want this to show up. So what color should I use? Silver? This is metallic silver. So let's do that and see if it shows up. I have a little bit in the cap, and this is just the dollar store makeup sponges. You don't want too much paint, but metallics are very sheer, so we'll see what happens. Hopefully we'll be able to see it. I'm probably going under it. I'm not the best stenciler. And because I'm going over the bricks, it's bumpy, and we'll see. We'll see what happens. Hopefully it'll show up. Hopefully I'm in the shot. I'm a little high up there. I was thinking of doing this again with the, like, either paste or maybe crackle paste or some type of other paste. But I think this will do the trick. And I think I'll put this down here. No, I think that's good. Yeah, we got a little clockage on there. I can see it. I'm going to put this guy right here. This big one. Yeah, this paint is really slippery and thin. So it could actually go under the stencils, just FYI. But I just want to, you know, a little metallic hint of a clock. And then maybe I can put in my, when I put my, what's it called? Sentiment, right? When I put my message on there, I'll use a clock and put time for spring or something. I don't know. We'll figure something out. All right, so I'm going to go away and let that dry. I'll be right back. Okay, I see it pretty well. I mean, yeah, that's a good shot. But it doesn't show up unless the pages turn, which I like. And actually, I guess it goes this way now because the clocks are... But I'm going to emboss. Now, embossing, I'm going to emboss with embossing powder this time. I'm going to use Versamark, which is just like a sticky ink that this powder will stick to, and then you heat set it. I have this clock stamp. And so I'm going to just, I don't know, I'm going to put a few clocks on here with embossing powder, and then I'm going to do it in black. I had a lot of different options. I could have done, do I want to do black? I think I'm going to do gold. I changed my mind. I have silver and gold. I'm going to do, since I did this in silver, let's make it gold. So this is Stampin' Stuff by Stampendous. Pirate, Pirate Gold, and this is called Just Gold by Recollections. And are they both fine? This is opaque. Detail embossing powder. I'm going to try the Recollections just because I don't know why. I'm just going to. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to just, can you see what I'm doing? Yeah. Take the top of this. This is a big stamp, so, and I'm just going to hit it here and sprinkle some on. Hopefully it'll stick. I'm going to cover this up. And yeah, I think it's sticking pretty good. Let's see what that looks like. Set that aside because I don't want to blow it or spill it. I'm going to get my heat gun and we're going to see. I like to let it heat up for a second. It. I'm going to do it in a couple more places. Let me put this back. Yeah, I'm glad I went with gold because it just shows up better. I have silver. I have so much stuff, you guys. That's why I'm trying to just use what you have. Like, I forget what I have. I have so much stuff, you know? So, let's see. I want to put some like in the middle on the bricks even. And see how that goes. I think it should work. I mean, I am not an embossing expert by any means. I don't do it often enough. So this is really like playing for me. And it's fun. I am having fun. Oh, it's a little messy. Maybe there were some wet spots in the, but let's do it. Let's see what we get. Cover it up. And I'll do one more little section down here. Maybe in the corner. And when you heat up the bricks, because they're the paste, they're kind of bubbling, which I actually like. I love it. All right, it's coming together. I think I'm just going to put maybe a little bit here. That's all. That's all I need. A little bit more. And you guys can forward through this if it's, you know, if you've seen enough already. I'm just going to pour it on there. Nice. You know what? This is fun. See, that's a thing. I'm trying to come up with my own designs and my own ideas because I've been a copycat all these years because of decorative painting. Decorative painting is a wonderful medium and way to get to do art, but this is my own ideas, and I'm feeling so brave and so happy that I am doing it myself. No one's telling me what to do. And you can like it or not. I don't mind. It's not for everyone. Can you see that changing? It's super cool. pretty happy, guys. I'm pretty happy with this. I just wish, like, I should stamp in a different color than the black. I could put some white. Yes, I'm gonna use white paint. Where's my white paint? I took it out. Where this color? No, I'm gonna use white. And I'm gonna put the brick stamp on with just white paint this time. So I'm gonna make a little palette here and just rub, because I don't have a white ink pad. I don't know if it exists, but I'm gonna do just a few of these in white. You know, my flip-flop makes these brick marks too. So that looks cool. I'm gonna wipe that off. I think we're in the home stretch. I don't think I want to add too much more. I could do drippage. That might be cool, because, you know, the only reason I say that is because I don't do drippage a lot. And I have, oh wait, I gotta use this to use up my paint. I don't do drippage a lot, and so I'm trying to use things to get used to it, and then I have just more tools in my head of things I can do. All right, now let me think. I think I want to add, I'm going to do my rubs now, because I wanted to add red for my bricks. Yeah, I'm going to do that now. I have the ink of gold. I'm going to add a little bit of water to it because, where's my squirt bottle? Because these get, oh well, it's kind of, actually no, it's good. It has moisture, see? It's on my finger. And I'm just going to go across. It's not turning out as dark as I'd hoped. I might actually want to paint the bricks. Oh no, that looks okay. Wait a minute. That looks good. Like, you can tell. Yeah, I think it's bringing it out more. And I have a copper color out here too. So let's see. Yeah, here's my water bottle. Let me just get this a little bit wet. And that way I don't have to rub as hard. Yeah, it's picking up the brick. Let's do this side. It's definitely making it bricky. It looks more bricky, right? And actually, drippage, see, I like it, but I think I might need to put it on other parts of the piece too, like on the white bricks. I'm gonna rub it over some of those places too to get. I like it. All right. I have the orange. It's actually copper. I do think I want to add this. This is dried up. And just hit and miss. I like it. It's orangey, but it's metallic. I don't want it to take over. Oh, that kind of did, didn't it? Yeah, that was. Is it taking over the red? I like it, and it adds to the metallic of the clocks, right? All right, it kind of looks like a lot right now. Like it's looking, I think we're going to calm it down with, we have to calm it down a little bit, I think. There's a lot going on. So I'm going to go away and come back. And we may just go over it with some white again and try to calm it down, or the blue. We'll see. All right, I'll be back. All right, I've decided to do something a little scary. I have no idea how this is going to turn out, but I'm going to add black. I just feel like it needs it, and I'm going to do drippage. So I'm going to create a little puddle here with my big brush and lots of water, because I don't have black in a fluid acrylic, or I would, you know what I have? No, I don't think I have black. I have black ink, but I'm just going to use paint. I do have black ink that I never use, like acrylic ink. I'm pretty sure I do, but let's just do this and hope for the best. Let me squirt the page too to get it to see what's going to happen here. Let's just loosen everything up. Loosen it up. Get some black drippage. And then I'll wipe it off maybe too. I'm liking it. I am. Let's see. I kind of want some here. I don't know how to get it to go like that. OMG, you guys. This is cool. Sorry, I know you can't see what's happening because of the angle that I have to hold the paper. I love it. Look. Oh my God, I love it. I love it just like this. Yeah, I'm not touching it. I love it. I don't know why, but I do. I have to get some of this black paint. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to spatter my, let's set that aside. I'm going to spatter this thing with this black. And this will be a background paper. I think I'm going to spatter my piece too. I just feel like it. Oh my God, I love it. I had no idea what that was going to do. But look at it. I think that is so cool. I kind of want some black here too. Maybe I'll take a risk and get carried away, which is what I always do. But I think I want some drippage right here. So let's just do it and... Yes. Oh, yes. This is scary, guys, but you know what? It's not that scary. It's just a piece of paper. And I'm having fun. So if it turns out, that's a bonus. But if it doesn't, I throw it away. It's not a big deal. But I love it. I really do. I really, really do. I think I'll set this aside and I'm going to brayer this black onto another deli paper and see what happens to that. So I'm just trying not to waste paper. Oopsie. And I'm so glad I did that. See, sometimes you just have to be brave. So let me wipe this. Just so I don't have a mess on my palette. and let me dry this with my heat tool. So I'll be back when it's dry. Alright, it's dry. I really like the way that turned out, although now I feel like I want to pop the bricks back up here. So I just got out the Inca Gold again, and I'm going to go over a few, and I'm a little bit stumped now. So I'm not sure where I'm going with it. I cut out a clock from a piece of scrapbook paper, and I don't think I want to use that. I'm not sure. That looks better though, because the bricks are in the foreground a little more, and then the black is like the mortar, you know. So yeah, that looks better. I like that better. It brings the bricks forward again. Do I need to use white? And what is the finished piece going to be? That's kind of what I'm thinking. Do I want to do big words? I cut this clock out, and I could put half there and half here, and then put the words kind of time for spring or something like that. I think that's what I'm, even though February, I mean, I think I'm going to do a Valentine's page too, because that's just fun. But for this page, I wanted it to represent the harshness of winter, but yet looking forward to spring, because we've had super great weather actually this winter so far. I like it though. I could do the edges. So I think I'm going to play around. This is from a paper line. I can't think of the name of the paper line. But it's just these big clocks. So I cut one out. I could use a super big one, but I think that medium one's going to be okay. And then I do think I want to use half and half. So I think I'm going to cut it in half. I'm going to fold it to get it to go. Let's see. No, I'm going to eyeball it. Just going to eyeball it. I'm usually pretty good at eyeballing stuff. Well, maybe not that part. That might be a little harder. And put half here. I think I want the bigger clock. I have the other, the paper comes in green too, but I didn't think I think I want to make this. I'm going to cut out the bigger clock. All right, I'll be right back. Alright, I've decided to just put this big clock in the middle. This is like, look guys, use what you have. All I'm trying to do is get you to realize that, and this is what I've learned now, because I had these other things. Look, I have, this is a little wooden, woodcut clock. I have these recollections. I get everything on clearance, but they've been in my stash forever. I have brads with clocks on them, but I'm sure, or even you could do a clock stencil and then cut it out and make it your focal point too. There's a lot of different ways you can go. I just happen to have this paper. I'm just going to put it down in the middle of here and put time for spring, because I mean, it's a little early for that. Probably March would have been, I'm going to have to come up with a theme for March. Comes in like a lion, goes out like a lamb, I don't know. But I love this background, just FYI. So I'm gonna glue this on, I'm just going to use, I think I am going to use, I'm going to use Mod Podge. I like Mod Podge. It's very sticky. So I'm first going to put some on the back of, I just used my grungiest brushes here. This is a good Mod Podge brush. And I am going to blend this into the background using paint and floating, you know, how I do, right? Put a little bit of Mod Podge in the middle. Hopefully it won't pull up a bunch of color or anything. Put this down. Yeah, that looks good. Straighten it out a little bit. And I'm going to do some blending this into the background with paint. So we'll get that on there. But this was fun. I had no idea, literally. Like, I'm just trying stuff this year. I'm getting out of my comfort zone. And I'm going to try and just create. I didn't see anybody else's February page. I mean, I guess I could put a little coat of this all over the place. Because what... Oh, excuse me. This is matte, though. Should I? I don't know. I think I'm just going to put a little on the other areas, too. What the heck? What the heck? Hopefully it doesn't... Because I used all acrylic paint, it's not going to fall apart. The only thing I'm not sure of is the, oops, see, some stuff is coming up right there. That looks like the matte medium. I mean, the, what is it called? The modeling paste. Yeah, this is the thing that's the most scary, is when you add a medium to your piece and you could risk screwing the whole thing up after you loved it. It looks like some of the red definitely came off onto my brush. See, look. And it got on my clock, but I think that blends it in even more. So I gotta let this dry, and then I'm gonna come back and finish it off with some shading around the edges and around the clock and the words. Alright, I'll be right back. Alright, it's all dry, and I love it. I do. I love that background. That is such a happy accident, because I had no idea what was gonna happen with that. I'm going to do a little bit of stamping. No, you know what? Yeah, I'm just going to do stamping because it's much easier with white. And I want to try and bring this into the background a little. Actually, should I do white? Yeah, I want to do white. Because I lost a lot of the white. You can still see some of it. Like if you look, let's see. Well, I love this part right here. But I think I'm going to stamp some white around and on here. So let's just do it. Let's just do it. And then I'm gonna put it back like in the background. I'm gonna shade around everything. So let's do some, I'm gonna use my brayer and this clock stamp and just hit it like that. I want to get a little on that black. I'm going to do a little bit on this brick stamp as well. Don't know where to put this. Right here and right here. And, oh, my tummy's growling. I got to eat lunch. It's about lunchtime. I gotta put some of this on here. Trying to use up this paint. I want to get it on here. What else do I want to do? I think a little bit of black. A little bit of black stamping. I'm going to get out my black stamp, let's say ink pad. Here it is. And what else did I use? That was it really, right? I'm gonna put bricks. I'm gonna go with the bricks and just kind of like that. Oop, a little dark, but I like it. All right, I think I'm good, but I can stamp this on here. All right. Now, that's a permanent ink, but I just put it on top of Mod Podge, so I'm not sure how that'll, if it's dry or not. So I'm going to make sure, because I'm going to come back with paint. Go in with, I think I want to use that original blue. Kiwi's with me. Hi, Kiwi. Oh my god, you guys, this in person is so freaking cool. Alright, this was the Deep Midnight Blue that I used originally. And I think I'm going to use that to shade, although the black, I think black would probably be cool too. I'm going to try this first, and I'm going to use my floating technique. That's what, let's get this white. Yeah, I'm trying to keep this short too, so that's why I keep going away and drying things off camera. And I mean, it's never short, don't get me wrong, because I take so long to do this, but I'm gonna use some of this and a big angle brush. So this is a half inch at least. Let's see, 3/4 inch angle. And water. I need paper towels. And I'm going to go around the clock. I corner load it and I keep the color on one end and the water on the other end. And I'm going to use a mop brush. And that's how I get a shaded effect. Yeah, this is good. This is going to be, it's going to bring the clock to the forefront. Oh, my tummy, sorry. I think I like the blue. I don't think I needed black, but I can always add a little bit of black. I'm gonna go around here. And yeah, that Inca Gold comes off. The red gets on my brush. So that looks cool. It's a little dark. I'm just softening it out. I gotta go into the, I'm getting my smaller, I can use the big one. I was just gonna change to a smaller angle brush, but I'm gonna use the same brush and go in here. Because I put that Mod Podge down, it's easy to wipe off the paint where you don't want it. But I just wanted it darker in there. I think we're done, guys. You know what I want to do, though? I want to go on the inside of the clock. I think I want to use, like, the copper, right? Didn't I put some copper? I wonder if this will show up the way I'm thinking. Or, you know what I'm going to use? I'm just going to use burnt umber. Oh, but I want it metallic. No, I'm going to use burnt umber. Sorry. Sorry. Burnt sienna. Yes. This is a little more of a reddish brown. And I'm going to put this on the inside edge of the clock. Kiwi, what you doing? You want to get in this paint and make footprints on my... So I'm going to put this right here and kind of differentiate the frame of the clock from the glass. And I think that did that. And then I kind of do want to put a metallic, something that would be, I don't want it to be, I'm going to use this copper. Bronze? No, I'm going to use the copper. Where's the copper? I just had it. Maybe just thin it down. Now see all that paint I just put out? I get to, I'm going to put it back in here. Yay. And I'm going to put this blue back too. People don't like to put stuff back in their bottles because it contaminates them. I don't care about contaminating stuff. I just don't. But I am going to try and put a little bit, like, about, I'm going to use, like, a little round brush. Why can't I find? That's a filbert. I want a round brush. There we go. The number two. I'm going to add water to it. Yeah, it's pretty opaque. But I want to make it metallic-y. It might be too much. Maybe if I blot it and just make it like in some places. Like, just subtly. I think that's cool. I'm keeping it. Right? And I mean, is it too much? See, I probably should have stamped on top of that before I did it. Oops. I got water. But I think we're done. I think I just want to put time for spring. Oh, I was also going to shade. I forgot that. I want to use that blue again. Or black. I think I'm going to do black this time. I'm going to just do it around the edges. Now, those of you who don't float, you could just use your inking, you know, ink the edges of your piece. But I'm just going to go down with some black. Just to frame it out a little bit. Man, that looks cool. Maybe I should go around the clock with black. Alright, I just gotta figure out what kind of letters I'm gonna use, and I'll be right back. Alright, I'm gonna stamp my letters. I rarely do this too. I'm going to stamp time for spring. T-I-M. These are the Stampers Anonymous F-O-R capital S. I'll go little. L-M-N-O-P-Q-R-S. What is it? Where's the P? This is the P. R-I-N-J. I-N-J. Yeah, I'm just going to do this with stamps. I never do this, and I'm going to use a piece of this deli paper that I just, so let's go with time. T. Because deli paper is good for collaging. It's not real thick, and it kind of blends in with the background. And that's what I want it to do. Time. Let's see what this looks like. Where's my E? Right here. Time. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. Maybe I'll go over it. Is that how you spell time? God, that looks weird. F, capital F, O, R, spring, capital S, P, R, I, N, G. Maybe I'll go over it with Posca's paint pens after this. Because it didn't come out that great, but at least I have an idea now where to go with it. And a lot of times when people use deli paper, they don't cut it because they don't like straight edges. They like to rip it. And I don't mind if you want to rip yours or not, but did I turn the camera on? I totally forgot. I'm just cutting it this time, and I'll see the difference. I've always just listened to everybody else and ripped it. So here's time for spring. Let's bring in time. Now the white on there, that's not going to blend into the background, huh? Time. For spring. And you can put it wherever you want. Time for spring. Time for. I'm going to do it like this. I'm going to put the spring right on the clock. I'm using a matte medium. No, did I use Mod Podge? I'm just going to use matte medium because I'm afraid of Mod Podge. It's a little stickier. Matte medium isn't as sticky. And I think I might tear. I'm very rough. And I might tear the paper if I do it with Mod Podge. So I'm going to see what happens, guys. I really, oops, I'll put it right here. Not sure what's going to happen. Time. Some of it will blend in with the background because of the white paint. Listen, this is new for me. Time for spring. Maybe I should have used clear paper, but that's okay. It's not going to ruin anything because my background is still there. I'm happy. I'm just going to let that dry and I'll go over my words with black paint or black pen, my Posca paint pen. I think that's going to be it. I'm just going to take this off. Right there. Yeah, so this is all new to me, But maybe, let's see if it was thin, it would have blended in with the background if I didn't use the, I think I don't like it. I'm going to take it off. Hey, listen. I changed my mind. It's my prerogative. So I'm going to stamp that out again, just on clear deli paper, and show you the difference. That may have worked or been a good idea for a different page, but I'm going to do it on here, and then I want to see it blend into the background, because I really do love my background, and I think I'd rather that shows through. So I'll be right back. I like it much better without the paint on the paper. I don't think it's blending in as much as, maybe I'm not using the right deli paper or something, but I think we're good. I think it looks very, very cool. And I'm not even going to go over it with a pen. And listen, you guys, make your own saying. You don't have to use time for spring, because maybe next month is time for spring, and I'm rushing it. But you can approach this. I'm going to write February on here, too. Approach it as you just want to have fun. And should I write it in white? February. Just have fun, play with tools that you haven't used before, and come up with a theme for yourself, and just make it happen. Let's zoom in though. I really, really love this background. This background was so fun to do. I used modeling paste, which I never use. I used two stencils that I never use. I used my Inca Gold. And then I still did it, and you know what, I ended up going around a few places with black just to bring the clock out a little bit. So there it is. All right, that's our page for February. I had fun. I hope you guys did. I might go around those words with white. I think I will. All right, you guys, thanks for watching.